Alongside Tommy Widdrington is assistant manager Alan Kimball. We caught up with Alan recently to find out more about his career and his role at Eastbourne Borough.
Alan, welcome. You've had an interesting professional career and played across the Football League. Tell us a bit about your time as a player.
As a player, when I was growing up, all I wanted to be was a professional footballer. Thankfully enough, that dream's come true. Like, even the boys here, they're all striving for one thing, is to be a professional footballer, and we just hope we can, well, we, me, myself and Tom, can take the club to where it should be, and we hope so in the not-distant future in the Football League. I had 5 years at Charlton as an apprentice and done a professional contract. And then I had 7 years at Cambridge under John Beck. I had a successful campaign, almost went consecutive seasons promotion from the fourth to, which is now the Premiership, which is the old First Division. And then I had 9 great years at Wimbledon, 7 years in the Premiership. Towards the end of my career, I had a year with Joe Kinnear at Luton as well. And then that's when I went into the non-league game with, had a year at Dagenham, and then filtered down and a successful career of 22 years. And then now it takes me, as my next profession, what I like to do is coaching on the football field.
So you've seen the game from all aspects. Do you ever wish you can put your boots on and get back on the park?
The next best thing is coaching and getting involved with the players day in, day out, the banter and that. I haven't missed that at all because I'm getting here when I was at Ebbsfleet, I had 4 good years there. And also now down at Eastbourne, now we've gone from the night training to the daytime training, which is the mentality of the boys, which is completely different this season, as you can see out on the football field.
As you mentioned, Ebbsfleet, and so you're coming up to another job in management. You come up to your first full year as assistant manager here at the Borough. What are your impressions of the club so far?
The club's been fantastic since me and Tom walked into the club. They've looked after us. They can't do enough for you. They've got so many, I think 80, 90 volunteers. It's a friendly club, and we've been welcomed with welcome arms. We're grateful for the opportunity what me and Tom have got, and we hope to be taking it with both hands. We ain't come here to stand still. We've come here to put the Eastbourne back on the map where they should be, at least in the Blue Square Premier.
Tell us a bit about your specific role as assistant manager. What areas do you actually focus on?
All aspects, really, first and foremost. I've got the rapport between myself and the manager, Tom, and the players. If they need anything, they come to me. You've got to have that little bit good cop, bad cop thing at the football club. And now I've got a good relationship with the players, and we have a good banter in the dressing room, on the training field. But they know the boys. When we get out there on the field, they know that it's serious. We prepare right. Everything gets done professionally as we can. And we go to games, myself, Tom. Assistant manager and also manager, it's a big part and parcel of the football club. You've got to make the players important at the football club, and that's what we're trying to do.
You mentioned about the banter. How hard has it been working with so many new players since the start of the season?
It's not that hard. We get the players in that I think will fit into the football club, into our structure of the football club or into our team. As you can see on the field, it takes time, which it has. The nucleus of the squad has changed from last season. We've only kept a small number from last season, but the boys who was here last year and the new boys, we've got a close-knit family. The team spirit is second to none here, just as well as when we had the crazy gang. Everyone's mucking in, as you can see on the football field. We're not that far away for being a very, very good team, and we hope it may continue with game tomorrow at Billericay. We win there, set us up nicely for the Christmas period, which is a very important part of the season. You get games thick and fast, and we hope to continue with our run. Prior to Saturday, we haven't lost away from home since the 29th of September, which was a big achievement for the football club.
You mentioned about the run. What's the most striking quality about the team developing now?
It comes with confidence, which we went through a little bit of a dicky patch. Every team's going to go through a dicky patch in the season. We've touched wood, we've had down. But now you can see the players, they're enjoying the daytime training, the atmosphere around the place. There's a buzz around the place, and which is a good vibe at the moment. It's a good place to be at the moment at Eastbourne Borough. And as I said, the Christmas period is a big, big important part of the season. It's not win or break, but it will put us nicely through over the Christmas period. We've got a little bit of a, myself and the gaffer, we've got goals for the season what we're going to set for, and we hope we just keep them to ourselves and we're just going along nicely. And we'll just see where it takes us.
Alan, thank you very much. We look forward to some good Christmas cheer over the next few matches, and compliments of the season and a happy new year to you.
And you, thank you very much.